Hey everyone, wanted to take a couple of minutes today to discuss an important difference between the technology sector and the mega cap technology and related stocks, and that's exactly also where the difference is. I think a lot of people have just kind of sort of come to the conclusion that, you know, these technology-ish names that we all know, from Google to Facebook to Apple and, you know, Amazon, all those, they're out there, they're all technology stocks, and they're really not, from a perspective of how they are being labeled or categorized in the equity market, particularly in the S&P 500. And that's an important distinction, because it really is important that we choose the right vehicles to express both either a bullish or a bearish view. And so, to express or to quickly show you this in the best possible manner, I took two ETFs. One of them is the QQQ Nasdaq 100 ETF. That one has its constituents over here on the right, and I'll walk you through this. And on the left, you have the actual sector ETF, of the S&P 500, the technology sector ETF. Ticker symbol is XLK. So XLK on the left, QQQ on the right. And so when you look at the Nasdaq 100, the QQQ, you will notice something very clear. You'll notice that there's Apple in the top holdings. There's Microsoft. There's Amazon. There's Tesla. There's Facebook. There's Google, i.e. Alphabet. And then the list goes on. But notice that Amazon is actually not really a technology stock in the way it's being labeled by the indices. It's actually a consumer discretionary stock. And then when you look at Facebook and Alphabet, even though they're part of the Nasdaq, which many people presume is just all technology, Facebook and Alphabet are actually communication stocks. So even though you could argue that these are technology companies, and I could certainly swing both ways from it, the way they're being labeled from the equity market, the way you're gaining exposure through them has to be very clearly defined. So for us, for instance, right now, we are quite cautious on mega cap stocks. And I'm going to say, you know, technology and related, and that will mean anything from Apple to Microsoft to Amazon, Facebook and Alphabet, even though they're not tech stocks, they're related in that space. So from that perspective, I don't really necessarily need to buy the Nasdaq 100, the QQQ. I would much rather be somewhere that's more diversified within technology itself. And one way to do that is to focus on the XLK ETF, even though this one has twice as much Apple almost, and almost twice as much Microsoft. It does have a more in-depth into different industries sort of diversified look in technology. So if I want to be long technology, and I'm going to quickly flip over to the chart here from a trading perspective, let's say, or even into the coming 3 to 6 months, maybe possibly beyond. Personally, I'd prefer to be an XLK versus QQQ, because it is a pure technology play, right? If you go back to the Nasdaq 100, let me quickly do that, you will see that the Nasdaq 100, the QQQ, actually has 23% of it is consumer cyclicals, right? 6% is healthcare, and so on and so forth. And so you very quickly end up in a situation where the Nasdaq 100 is really not the same thing as a pure technology exposure. Now, technology is a very broadly diversified sector, to be clear, right? There's technology in healthcare that has nothing to do with, you know, technology, like, you know, I don't know, something totally different. Let's put it that way without going too detail. Like software makers, right? That really is a totally different business, but they're both technology. So from that perspective, even though the charts right now, XLK versus here's QQQ, look very similar, I would not be surprised if we could start to see some fairly notable, initially subtle and then notable differences in terms of performance going forward if we were to see the technology sector as a broader sector continue to do well, but the mega cap stocks, again, whether they're tech or not, or related, right? So that would include a Facebook or an Alphabet, to maybe start to be somewhat underperforming. Not, I'm not talking about these being bad companies and collapsing. It's not the point, but relative underperformance. So I just want to spend a few minutes on that. I hope this is helpful. If you guys have any questions or comments, let us know. And we'll see you again soon.